On December 25th, 2017, the grass will turn blue and the sky will turn green. And when I walk outside with my fanny pack, which I wear for practical reasons, I won't feel insecure about it this holiday season. On Christmas Day, I'll climb into an Uber with my guitar, and the driver will say nothing. He will simply drive his car. He won't ask what style I play, or whether I play rhythm or lead. He will not inform me that he's a producer, but also plays a little bit of keys. I'll answer the phone that day to hear the voice of my mother, who died of liver failure when I was 15, and I will weep as she tells me that she's been given a second chance, that she's entering the program, that she wants to be there for her grandchildren, and that she swears she'll never leave me again. And as we hang up, I'll pull out a picture of you and say if the sky has turned green and the grass has turned blue, then maybe I won't. The insipid pap that makes up the iTunes top 10 will be uniformly supplanted by just one song. You've Lost That Love and Feeling by the Righteous Brothers. And why? Because You've Lost That Love and Feeling is a fucking incredible song and it deserves to be numbers 1 through 10. And we will play it on repeat and we will exclaim, my God, we have lost that love and feeling. We've given in to our worst instincts and that love and feeling is fucking gone, gone, gone. And as the song reaches its climax, we will fall to our knees and wail along with Bobby Hatfield as he sings, please bring it on back. In which he directly addresses his parents, his management, and his fans. And he will say, I was just a dumb kid who wanted to sing Usher songs on YouTube, but you turned me into a prize animal. You robbed me of my childhood. You robbed me of my humanity. And when I look in the mirror now, I can hardly even recognize my own face anymore. All I see is this fucking golden calf. And President Donald Trump, glued to his TV, will recognize his ascension as the nadir of the cult of personality societal dynamic addressed in that press conference. And he will not tweet his response, but rather, he will go door to door to every house in America. And he will say, I'm sorry, I've been wrong about a lot of things. My character defects were constructed in order to keep me safe from feelings of fear, loneliness, and insecurity that have haunted me for my entire life. I promise to be a better person. Moreover, I promise to be a better president. And afterwards, he will not tweet about how well received this effort was, but rather, he will go hope those